Tonight from the Hudson Sports Complex in Warwick, New York, it's NISA Soccer Action. The National Independent Soccer Association has Stumptown AC. Charlotte, North Carolina based, they make the trip up north to pay a visit to New Amsterdam FC, the second-year New York-based club. Good evening and welcome to our coverage on MyCujo.tv. Alongside former Columbia All-American keeper Sal Rosamilia, I'm Ralph Bidnarczyk. Stumptown in its first year as a rebranded organization, an entire roster that has been together less than 2 months. Sal, they play their second game in 3 nights today, making the road trip, and they pay a visit to New Amsterdam club still seeking its first win.
Yeah, really difficult to ask for Stumptown. Travel in between second game in 3 nights, third game actually in 7 days. So for them, really a difficult ask, especially a team that likes to possess the ball, likes to have it, likes to play on the front foot, likes to press when those opportunities are there. It's going to be interesting to see if they have the legs to do just that.
And for Stumptown AC, they've been seeking who will meld this team together. They found a terrific midfielder, center mid Luis Garcia Sosa, a pair of assists, and he looks like he is going to be an engine.
Yeah, well, if they're in possession of the ball, chances are he's going to have the most touches for Stumptown tonight. So that's who they want to play through. Very good technically. You'll see them again. It's a possession team. They like to play through the midfield, and Sosa's certainly a player that they're going to look to get on the ball early, often, keep the rhythm of the game going, and try to link in with the forwards at times.
And for New Amsterdam, their holding midfielder from day one this season has been Michael Cafari.
Yeah, Cafari brings a championship pedigree to New Amsterdam, a Detroit City player, a big part of what they did with their championship last year. Brings leadership, brings a lot of professional experience, and he brings a real bite to the midfield. So he's going to be one of those guys for New Amsterdam. He's going to try to break up the play, try to counter what Garcia Sosa is trying to do for Stumptown in terms of possession. And if you're going to see Cafari making a lot of tackles, breaking up a lot of passes, I think you're going to see New Amsterdam having a good go tonight.
Is this the night for NAFC, Stumptown AC, on the back end of a very difficult week? We're coming back with NISA Soccer Action on MyCujo.tv.
York streets will kill us a walk like Pistol Pete and Pappy Mason. Gave the young boys admiration. Prince from Queens and Fritz from Harlem, street legends.
New Amsterdam and Stumptown AC tonight from the Hudson Sports Complex in Warwick, New York. Let's give you our starters. Stumptown AC first-year coach Rod Underwood. They lost this past Wednesday night against LA Force, and part of that lineup will show you the terrific Luis Garcia Sosa, but Kevin Gonzalez, a 5'11 keeper from Hayward, California, in the back. Reese Williams, a Columbia graduate with Robert Hines outside. Krim and Frankie Martinez are the center backs. Part of a 4-5-1. The engine, of course, Garcia Sosa, the center mid. Left mid, Travis Ward. Opposite him with Alex McGrath. And inside, Ishmael Longo. And up top, Molly Carpe. And the holding mid is the very steady player inside in Giovanni Bejarano Navia. And for New Amsterdam tonight, Jesse Cork will once again be the keeper. Sal Barone, the left back, with Daniel Vicente outside. Armando Guarnera, Mohamed Kone are the two center backs playing at a 4-4-2. And how about the midfield? The striker up top tonight will be Arthur Bajwa, who makes the start, product out of Colombia, just in his first full week with Cafari, the holding mid, Fernando Cortez, the center attacking mid, up top also with Angulo and Siobhan John Brown on the right with Maele Malango on the left. Sal, our keys to the game. Well, this is a program in Rod Underwood that is trying to establish a dominant possession side How about executing that?
Yeah, it's even more important for Stumptown tonight, as we already mentioned. They just played Wednesday night, had to travel yesterday to get here to play New Amsterdam, and it's their third match in 7 days. So if they're without the ball tonight, it means they're working extra hard on defense. So possession is especially important for the success for Stumptown tonight.
And New Amsterdam cleaned it up. They've allowed 9 goals, a lot of them due to some errors on their own end.
Yeah, you can point to some mistakes, some glaring mistakes that have led to some of the 9 goals that they've allowed in the 5 matches. They've got to clean that up, and they also got to clean it up in the box offensively. They've had possession in the final third in their first couple of games here. They've not really been clean in the box with their chances. Both ends of the field really need to get a little cleaner for New Amsterdam to get their first win.
Stumptown AC, Charlotte, North Carolina based. Going back to the Legends Cup, they're 2-2-1 overall. Wednesday night, they gave up an early goal to the LA Force in the 11th minute. And they were unable to muster the equalizer. And trying to salvage this week, this is also their third game in 7 days, going back to last weekend. Luis Diego Arroyo, our center referee. The teal on teal for New Amsterdam. Stumptown AC in the Navy on Navy, and we are underway. Clear skies, great conditions, temperature at about 71 as we open up this evening. So that dominant possession style, Rod Underwood coming over from a club in Jamaica. He is known for being a top assistant at the MLS level with the Portland Timbers, and a great pickup for the Stumptown club that hired him only on March 20th. And this roster came together remarkably quickly, and many players finding their way on due to open tryouts. Rod Underwood got about 50 phone calls in a 48-hour period, and 1,000 players offered. This is a ball sent in and right at Jesse Cork, who will handle it quickly and look to distribute.
Always nice to get that first easy touch as a goalkeeper, give you a little bit of confidence early in the match.
Mali Carpe, forward from Liberia, 26-year-old. Big and strong. He is the striker up top that just had that shot. Opening segment of the game brought to you by the business of business, B2B. Then this is a ball played across, and it had to be parried out. Kevin Gonzalez was down, and there was a rebound for the taking for New Amsterdam.
Yeah, tough first touch on the other end for Gonzalez. Cork had an easy one. Gonzalez a difficult one. And unfortunately for New Amsterdam, no one right on the door. It's a good run, driving run forward by Malango. A dangerous ball in the box, just missed Bajua at the near post, and nobody following up for that rebound that was available.
Arthur Bajua making the start for New Amsterdam. He came off the bench, Sal, last Friday and gave New Amsterdam some pretty good minutes in replace of Bledi Bardic, and the talented longtime NISA player who is well known for his years with the New York Cosmos, will sub in tonight. Here is Siobhan John Brown to the feet of Bajua. Now Malango looking to attack. Maeli Malango on the fine turn and just at the edge of the box and did not find a trailer.
Yeah, good start to the match here. 2 minutes in, and it's been up and down already. Good first touch there by Bajua just outside the box, and he's going to give you a real number nine, a true striker. Great size, strong on the ball, can play with his back to the goal. Gets his teammates involved. Like to see him and Jose Angulo tonight.
Ball sent across, and for Bajua, he will team up with his former Columbia teammate, Reese Williams, who's the starting left back for Stumptown AC. They have a nice friendly bet between the two of them. Bajua, and he'll drop it off and leave it out wide for Daniel Vicente, and out of his reach.
Well, we'll see how long it's going to continue for Stumptown, but early on, they're playing with a lot of pace. We saw some pressure early on Jesse Cork, so maybe when those opportunities come about, again, we're going to talk about it often. We'll see what the fitness level is like early in the season for this Stumptown athletic team. But to ask to play 2 matches with a travel in between in 72 hours is an awful lot, and to keep up this pace for 90 minutes as well. But you know that's how New Amsterdam's going to play. They're high pressure. They're counter-pressing team. They get numbers forward. Plenty of dynamic players, especially we'd like to see Daniel Vicente get forward from that right back position a little more. He's very, very good. An offensive-minded player playing at right back right now. The ability to serve some really dangerous balls if he can get himself up the field.
This is Frankie Martinez from Englewood, New Jersey, 25-year-old. One-time draft choice by Sporting KC in the third round 2 years ago, the MLS Super Draft. A restart coming for Stumptown AC, who defeated New Amsterdam 1-0 at the end of the Legends Cup less than a month ago, April 22nd, took place in Chattanooga. But Rod Underwood coaching Stumptown used that essentially as a preseason period. Of course, everybody wanted to win, but he had his roster together for less than 2 weeks as Cork, under great pressure, is able to release briefly.
A very, very confident move there by Jesse Cork. Did really well as Luis Garcia Sosa. Flag is up for offside, but under a lot of pressure from Sosa. Really coolly, Cork was able to get out of it. But Stumptown, you know, it could be, and they took in an early goal in their last match, a 1-0 loss to Los Angeles on Wednesday night. But now them being on the road, they might be looking for that early goal, try to get something early like happened against New Amsterdam last week against Detroit City. And then maybe look to make that one goal work here. New Amsterdam has had difficulty scoring goals so far this year, only two in five matches.
Vicente looked to play Malango in. Reese Williams. And Williams to play it back. Williams, left back from White Plains, grew up in Weston, Florida, suburb outside of Fort Lauderdale. Cork, Sal Barone, back as the starting left back tonight. New Amsterdam playing without their left back to begin the season. Sakeli Sylvester, terrific story, dealing with a hamstring injury as we're going to get a foul at midfield. And that is Travis Ward that is shaken up. Left midfielder of Ocean City that had an incredible career at Division III Rowan down in South Jersey. 29 career goals, three-time first-team All-NJAC. And last year, he had some NISA experience, two games played with the Michigan Stars. This Stumptown roster has a wide variety of experience, but there are some ex-NISA players and players that have rostered that was attractive to Rod Underwood in the free agent process. A lot of USL Championship Division players too. Space for Travis Ward. William is in along, Frankie Martinez. Kevin Gonzalez, as they described him, they like his feet. They want to be able to play through the keeper. Gonzalez 2 years ago on the very first Oakland Roots team as a backup goalie from the San Francisco area. Barone. Kone, poor first touch. Opportunity for a counter. Here's the chance. Here's Carpe, and Carpe had it played out. Molly Carpe. That'll be a touch off New Amsterdam in an early corner for Stumptown AC. Again, nearly a devastating turnover.
Yep, and Guarnera there was able to get in. It's a good first touch there from Carpe, but you see Guarnera just getting his body in the way, able to knock it out for a corner kick. Again, coming off a turnover, Stumptown is looking to take advantage. It seems like certain opportunities, maybe certain players specifically, and then they're coming with a full high press, and it nearly led to the first goal.
Luis Garcia Sosa, corner. Goal kick, Jesse Cork and New Amsterdam.
Yeah, Guarnera, Armando Guarnera really saved the day so far there for New Amsterdam. Carpe thought he maybe had a little bit more time. His first touch was actually really good, but tremendous recovery from Guarnera. keep this game scoreless for now. But that was what we had talked about in the keys, Ralph, is just having to be a little bit cleaner, and it's those types of things. You know, everybody is pressing these days, certainly opportunistic pressing when it's there, if not a full-out press for 90 minutes. And we've seen it a couple of times already from Stumptown. We know New Amsterdam is going to do that any chance they get as well. But we've seen a couple of opportunistic presses from Stumptown lead to dangerous opportunities. And that's what needs to get cleaned up. It's okay, especially early in a match, to lump a ball up the field, to just hoof it up there. If you feel like you're under pressure, you can't afford to give up an early goal, especially when you've been struggling to score yourself.
Carpe did well to take it back. Cortez to the outside for Barone. And this bounces into the box for Kevin Gonzalez. And now room for Reese Williams, who had a goal against Cal United in the Legends Cup. A lot of experience for the left back through the USL with South Georgia Tormenta. And these two teams share that common bond from the last week, with Stumptown giving up a goal Wednesday night in the 11th minute to lose to LA. 1-0. Last Friday night, New Amsterdam right here in Warwick giving up a 15th minute goal to Detroit City and falling by the same score. John Brown, the breakup.
And that's okay. Sometimes, again, now we're seeing the high press from New Amsterdam. All 10 of their field players deep in the offensive half for New Amsterdam. So Stumptown not afraid to just release some of that pressure with a 40, 50-yard ball trying to find the target, Carpe.
Next segment of this match brought to you by Fruit Street this evening from Warwick. John Brown trying to hold it up, or rather Malango. And the right back Hines sends forward. Angulo. Throw in coming for a Stumptown AC. Stumptown rebranding. The organization and club was sold in the offseason. They returned just three players from the 2019-20 season, and two of them starters in the holding midfielder, and Giovanni Bejarano Navia and Ishmael Longo. Last spring, they played two matches, a pair of ties before the pandemic, and did not return, elected not to come back. Went 4-2 in the fall of 2019 as a club, their first season before rebranding, and an entire new ownership group and management. Vicente is fouled by Ward.
See some frustration there from Vicente. Wants that ball a little bit earlier. If he's going backward with it, it's because he realizes maybe this side of the field is closed down for now. Maybe look to recycle that to the left side. But the pressure from both teams, especially in that middle third of the field, is causing some trouble.
Williams does well to take it up the sideline. Reese Williams to continue. Starter most of his 4 years at Columbia.
Very versatile player, too. He's playing left back here for Stumptown. He played left back, right back at Columbia. But really, when he first got to that program, was more of an attacking player, a wide midfielder. Great pace, great work rate. Certainly an ability to go forward. Maybe left back is the right position for him.
Good ball played over the top. Angulo. And Angulo, a good job closing off the angle. Jacob Krim, the center back, did not play anywhere last year, came to the open tryout and made the club.
But that's the kind of ball that has to be played sometimes. It's the first time we've really seen that longer ball played tonight by New Amsterdam. Stumptown's done it a couple times. Turnover here.
Bazua, good ball laid in. Malango with room. Malango, and that's off the body of Martinez. Yeah, he was looking for that far post.
Yeah, I think he was actually looking for a shot there towards that far post. I don't think it was going to be on goal. Fortunately for New Amsterdam, deflected over the end line for a corner kick. But right off a turnover, good play by Bashua. Great pass, perfectly weighted, right speed, right to his feet. That first touch again is going towards the corner flag instead of towards the goalkeeper. It makes that next touch, that shot, much more difficult to get on target. But good chance here for New Amsterdam.
First corner for NAFC. Kafari. And New Amsterdam looking to settle and possess that second ball. Carpe doing some great work defensively. Hines to play it out. Follow-up played out of the reach of Fernando Cortez and a chance to counter. Garcia Sosa out wide. Carpe to power through and Mali Carpe to continue before New Amsterdam able to get back defensively and counter. And that ball did carry across the end line, so it's going to lead to a gift corner for Stumptown AC via the counter.
And this comes not long after the corner kick by New Amsterdam, and it was taken by Salvatore Barone, who is the left back for New Amsterdam. And that is right where Stumptown recognized, okay, the left back's taking the corner high up the field, and they attacked in his vacated position and now leads to this dangerous opportunity and a corner kick for Stumptown.
Garcia Sosa, and does not beat the first defender. Follow-up volley. Giving that a ride.
Yeah, I have no problem.
Alex McGrath.
Sorry, Ralph. No problem with Barone going and take it. I mean, from that side of the field, the left-footed in-swinging corner, he has the ability to play a great ball. But you've got to balance the field and recognize he's as far away from possible if you lose possession from his defensive position that where he needs to be. And they almost got caught there. We've seen early is Mali Carpe for Stumptown is going to be a handful. He does a lot of work that goes unnoticed, doesn't get the ball served to him each and every time. He's the lone forward in a 4-5-1 formation tonight, but boy, is he putting in the work, putting in the effort, and every time he's had the ball at his feet, it's been a scary deal for the defender who's closest to him. He's got power, he's got pace.
Yeah, Mali Carpe coming to Stumptown via a recommendation, a friend of Rod Underwood. Had experience playing for the then Atlanta Soccer Club in NISA back in 2019. And there's Rod Underwood on the left, and what a remarkable career he has had in a lot of different stops. Startup experience too with the Sacramento Republic FC in 2015. Recently head coach of Montego Bay United in Jamaica. Boarded a red eye March 20th from Seattle to Charlotte, and that's where all those phone calls started to begin, and the lines opened up with players realizing still during a pandemic there's an opportunity for a pro contract. And he, along with Director of Operations Cary Taylor, Assistant Eric Immler from the early days of the MLS with the DC United, were able to put together a roster after fielding, again, a remarkable 1,000 players offered via agents and 50 phone calls just each of them. It was a lot that they had to put together. Hines out wide. Garcia Sosa. Martinez and out of the reach of Williams. Amidst the style of play that Stumptown hopes to establish, as we touched on, is a ball-dominant style. Big person in his coaching career, Preki. Great friends from back during their time in Sacramento. Preki, the former Serbian-American football manager and MLS coach with Toronto and Chivas.
And one of the top players ever in Major League Soccer, certainly Preki.
And Max Mansfield in his second year, still looking for that first win. And they're building, and they're trying to find the right pieces. He's made two starting lineup changes from last Friday. As he told us last week, we can get 5% better on the offensive end, 5% better in our defensive box or defensive third. We're right there towards having a breakthrough and to climb up the standings that are very much jumbled up through two matches in this spring season.
Well, they've done the defensive part, I would say even more, much better than 5% better. The first two matches of the season in April, they gave up three goals in each. Their last three games since, they've lost all three of them by a 1-0 score. So the defense has gotten much, much better. It's still the offensive end where things are lacking for New Amsterdam. That's where they need. They got to find somebody to get the goals. There's a difference in the starting lineup tonight with Arthur Boshua up top. He certainly has a history of scoring a bunch of goals, and I think he's capable certainly at this level. And if they can find that with the much better defense the last three matches, that's where they'll find the wins.
Boshua just signed on May the 4th and fell into this club's lap after the Charleston Battery of the USL Championship. Did not pick up his option, a 2018 Columbia graduate. 27 career goals there, Sal. Second team All-American in 2017. And what does he offer at this level, at the NISA level?
Well, what he's always offered, and I think it's a bit of a mistake, Charleston, not keeping him around. It's a target player, a dominant player in the box, can play with his back to the goal. We've already saw him lay off a perfect ball for an opportunity for one of his teammates as well. But he needs touches in and around the box. He's just a goal scorer, finds ways, whether it's with his head, with his feet, off a deflection, any way possible. If he gets some touches inside the box, you give him five half chances in a game, he's going to get a couple goals for you.
Ball played in is this segment of the broadcast presented by the Foosball Project. No score, 21st minutes tonight in Warwick, New York. New Amsterdam FC still seeking the club's first victory. Will tonight be the night Stumptown AC playing their second match in three nights and third in seven? Barone, and a slide tackle that's going to go against Sal Barone. And our official is going to explain to him, no, Luis Diego Arroyo. No card, but a stern talking to as he tackled Ismael Longo.
Yeah, and you saw, I think we're going to see it here. It's that pass there that's not great. And I think that was from Jose Angulo, and Angulo apologized to Barone. It was an in-between ball. It was a bit of a weak pass. Angulo knew as soon as he played it, he put his arm up as if to say, hey, I'm sorry for that one. And the referee did give a talking to. No card yet, but Barone is on watch.
McGrath looked to play in a cross. And it'll belong to a goal kick and Jesse Cork as this match has leveled off. Pair of half chances perhaps we can offer for Stumptown AC. Best chance overall for New Amsterdam coming off the foot of Maeli Malango on a ball that he just could not square up, ended up as a corner for New Amsterdam that they weren't able to generate a chance off of. To the feet of Siobhan John Brown. And Malango out wide quickly. Good ball wide. Vicente. Daniel Vicente sprays it across. There's a man in the air. And that was Boshua. It's over the bar. But great transition. A counter for New Amsterdam. And Arthur Boshua found himself on the receiving end.
Man, that's what he is. 6'4", maybe even a little bit taller. It's a good ball in from Vicente. And Boshua clear up and above. gets his head on it, just not able to get on top of that ball, heading it down towards the goalkeeper, just over the bar. But need to see more of that from Daniel Vicente, perfectly capable of getting forward, serving those dangerous balls into the box, and he's got a big target now in Bashua to look for.
Nearly a giveaway, Bajua, seventh all-time at Columbia in both goals scored and points. You're a very proud alma mater. And Siobhan John Brown he's frustrated. He's going to be the one called for the foul and will plead his case. Jacob Krim, McGrath with the connection, wide with Hines, and McGrath with a good ball, and some space here for Ishmael Longo. And Stumptown was able to build up. They'll have the toss in through Garcia Sosa, who has not had opportunities on the ball yet to really accelerate.
I was just thinking that as you mentioned it, Ralph. New Amsterdam has done a good job denying the ball to Garcia Sosa. We know that that's where Stumptown would like to play through, and now as we speak about him, he gets the most touches he's had in the entire match so far.
And then able to check back to it from Valencia, California, born in Juarez, Mexico. Nice ball laid in. Oh, and if not for Longo running into Armando Guarnera, you could certainly credit Guarnera for the good defending there, but that was a great layoff that if Longo does not run into him, he might be in free and clear.
Yeah, and that was a neat little ball there from Garcia Sosa. He looked like he was going to dribble with his right foot towards the middle of the goal and maybe look for his own shot, and then he just kind of flicked it with the outside of his left foot. Perfect pass and a good play by Guarnera, breaking it up. We've seen that a couple of times from Armando Guarnera so far tonight, getting his body in the way more than just clearing the ball away and relieving some pressure. That's a bad foul there. Referee going to call an advantage, and rightfully so.
McGrath instead will take the shot. And now Stumptown AC wondering why that wasn't whistled down eventually after the shot by McGrath.
Well, because the advantage had been played, and the next play, you get a shot on goal, you're not going to bring it back at that point. Referee was perfectly right there to allow the advantage. Stumptown would have been furious if the whistle was blown as that dribble was happening.
Garcia Sosa comes up with it, looks for numbers. Luis Garcia Sosa, then he looked to play in Williams, the left back. Follow-up comes to Hines. And Robert Hines in the San Francisco area pursues before Kafari the clearance.
Well, you could see Garcia Sosa wants to get that ball on his left foot every chance he can. He actually seems like he got a knock. He's hobbling on the far side of the field, holding that right leg up in the quad area. He got cracked pretty good there. He's trying to run it off as we see, but we've seen it twice now. He wants to get the ball to his left foot. That's where it's most comfortable. He was trying to line that up for a shot.
And he is proven to be, for a brand new club with basically all new faces, he's been proven to be the indispensable guy so far in these 6 weeks they've been together. Has two assists. Last year did not appear in any of the Stumptown EC games. This has been the breakthrough for the 23-year-old in his career. Nearly made the Orange County FC club at the USL Championship Division 2 years ago. He was one of three guys out of 150 that came to an open tryout that was invited to trial with the team for a period, but ended up never rostering or being signed. As Siobhan John Brown will blast it off of Williams. Deep throw coming for New Amsterdam.
And here it is, and this is a great job by the referee. This is the first time that the ball has gone out of play since he called the advantage, and now he has the opportunity to give the caution to number 27, Michael Kafari.
Keeper,
that's just great refereeing. The advantage was allowed. It was a good opportunity on the counter by Stumptown. The shot came. It didn't lead to anything. The play continued. The ball finally goes out of bounds, and the referee does give the caution to Michael Kafari.
First yellow of the match. Vicente plays it across. McGrath heads it out.
And that's tough for Kafari because, you know, we talked about it in the open, Ralph. He's going to grind in the midfield. He's going to play with some bite. He's going to try to break up tackles. He has to be a little bit careful now that he's playing with a caution less than 30 minutes into the match. Can't afford to get a second one, obviously, and force New Amsterdam to play a man short.
And like Garcia Sosa, if there was someone you would call indispensable to this New Amsterdam lineup, in terms of who would you go if you had to replace him, there doesn't appear to be an obvious candidate to play holding mid off the New Amsterdam bench for Kafari. Barone over the top, Angulo. Martinez, nice first touch. Frankie Martinez.
And another run by Carpe. Again, you might not see it if you're not at the match. It doesn't always get caught by the camera, but Carpe just keeps making run after run after run from the nine position. Dummy runs a lot of the time. He's drawing defenders, just putting in the work. Hasn't had a ton of touches, but you just feel that if he gets half of an opportunity again in this game, he did have one little bit of a chance. If he gets another, I won't be surprised if he's able to finish it.
Carpe to check back. Molly Carpe. And now able to power through the edge of the box, then continuing, and he misses to the short side, but great moves from the powerful Molly Carpe.
Yeah, what a handful. I mean, he's got some quick feet. You could see just a real powerful striker, has put in a bunch of work already. But you don't think a guy this big can do what he just right there, kind of squeezed through, and then just hits an absolute rocket not far off the target from Carpe. You know, you like to reward your strikers. He's doing a bunch of work. He's pressing. He's making runs. You like to find him, and you like to get him some more of those opportunities. You can see how dangerous he is.
Next segment of this broadcast presented to you by Fruit Street. Scoreless in the 31st minute as Bajua tangles with a right back. And Bajua will be the one that commits the foul.
They're not happy about it. Perhaps the defender went down a little bit easy there. You'll usually see the benefit of the doubt go to the defensive team. And Baja was maybe asking for a dangerous play as the defender's just kind of standing in on the ball. But you know, New Amsterdam loves to play with pace, loves to play with speed, loves to get the ball forward fast, get numbers forward into the game. But, you know, I think if they slowed it down just a little bit for a while here and tried to just hold the ball, tried to have possession a little bit more, knowing that Stumptown just played a game Wednesday night, knowing that this is their third match in seven games, they had to travel yesterday to get here. If they can get possession, if they can hold it, if they can get Stumptown chasing the game a little bit, you know, I think later in the match they could see some benefits to that. But, you know, they have their style. It's an attractive style. They like to play forward, fast, get numbers forward, outside backs. All that stuff is great. But to try to get a result in this match, you want to keep the ball. Those are some tired legs you would expect from Stumptown.
Carpe was the target man. Travis Ward. Williams to settle. Carpe to check back. And then look for support. Nice run was made away from him by Garcia Sosa. And now it is Malango. Kafari, nice switch. Barone. 25-year-old from Brooklyn in his first year with New Amsterdam. Been the challenger at left back as Bajua. Malango. Malango had a runner coming, and it's knocked down off the body of Williams and Kevin Gonzalez to gather.
Yeah, tried to look for a run near post, like you said. Tried to curl it around Williams, but right off his chest. Easy collection for Gonzalez.
Longo. Could not connect there with Garcia Soso. Ward with a nice tackle to take it away from Cortez. Ishmael Longo, the return to Ward. Robert Hines, California from the San Francisco region, the right back. This is Longo. Martinez and Stumptown AC starting to generate that dominant possession style that Rod Underwood has been trying to implement with a team full of new faces. Reese Williams. Now Garcia Sosa to pivot and be their engine. Williams got around Vicente. Then sprays it across. A head ball is there. And it could not be finished. The offsides flag is up anyway, but a fine buildup as Stumptown AC about put together 15 passes that were nearly paid off. It is Travis Ward that is down in the New Amsterdam goal.
Yeah, and it was and Cork is hurt a little bit as well, but you see a nice move there by Reese Williams, and then the cross comes in, perhaps being grabbed there by Vicente. The initial header was fine. It was that second header that put Ward in the offside position, and he and Cork came together. They're both down right now, but we see it again. Good move by Reese Williams. Gets it to his left foot. Great ball in. This first header is okay. That wasn't the offside. It was the second head, the second touch there by Travis Ward. And we see the goalkeeper, Cork, who made a phenomenal save, and Ward both coming together. And, you know, they both look very questionable right now, whether either one continue. Last week we saw Cork appeared to hurt his left shoulder late in the match. He's been dealing with that all week. This seems like more of a knock to the right hip. And for Travis Ward, it was a great opportunity. I'm sure he wishes he knew that he was in an offside position and just kind of let it go to avoid this. Hope that both continue, but what a save. It won't go down in the stat sheet as an official one because of the offside, of course, but watch this great reaction save by Cork. Amazing with the right hand, and it's that there. You see Ward is kind of maybe grabbing his lower right leg, and Cork was able to get up quickly, but I think he kind of got blasted into his hip as well. Travis Ward is up and seems like he's going to continue. And for Cork, I'm not so sure right now.
Jesse Cork, 28-year-old, in his first year with New Amsterdam, 2 years with the Cosmos Sal. You and I saw him and how fiery of a competitor he is. Starring at Division II Molloy College, where he was goalie of the year in that league in 2014. And a four-year starter. And he has long ties with Max Mansfield, who helped get him his pro start in Germany. And it's like family for him. So it was an easy decision. Once Cork saw that the Cosmos were going to be on hiatus, he decided to sign over here with New Amsterdam and stay in NISA.
Yeah, this doesn't look good. I can't imagine he's going to be able to keep going. No, that's it. They're going to have to make a change there.
Yep, Jesse gave it an opportunity, but when you talk about a hip, Sal, you were a keeper, and he tried to find his base there.
Yeah, I mean, all we see is just a wonderful save. Not sure if it came from contact with Ward or planting here. You know, maybe his leg got snapped back, but he's up in a ready position immediately after the save. Maybe it was just the adrenaline that was going. Again, this is so unfortunate because Ward was offside. Cork looks like he's going to try to give it a chance, but every time he finds that one spot there, they have to make a change because every time he has that one spot, it looks like, you know, someone's just jabbing him with a knife.
Well, I think we have the indication now with the cart coming out, and for New Amsterdam, this could be a season-changing situation. And I think Cork does not want to sit in the cart just yet.
Well, you could see he's okay with some movements, but then there's that just that one little spot there where he twists it or turns it, where he just feels that sharp pain that I can't imagine he's going to be able to play through this, but certainly he's going to try. We've seen the universal kind of substitution signal from the training staff a couple of different times. I think for sure it's that hip pointer, upper part of the right outside hip there. That
there's Muhammad Kata, Sal, 6'3", from the Bronx, the Ivory Coast. He's the backup tonight. He's been a battle with Aldo Munoz, the dress behind Cork. And here's this opportunity, 2019 Mercy College graduate. Played in just three career games there. He was behind a terrific all-conference goalie, but found his way into the fifth league in Berlin. And a local guy is the backup keeper. And he may have his first opportunity unless Cork can talk his way into staying in this match.
Yeah, I don't know how he can try to. I mean, he's given it a best effort, and certainly appreciate the toughness and the willingness to try to play through pain. But at some point, I think he's got to do the right thing and has to come off for his own well-being, and also, I just can't imagine him being able to push off that right leg, you know, much less maybe dive on that right hip. But wow, I guess I'm wrong.
Well, the cart's leaving without Jesse Cork. This segment of the game being presented by Morgan Lewis. The other aspect too, Sal, is we're close to the half. He's going to have to go back inside the locker room and find a way to stay loose for that 15-minute period, come back out and play the second half. I'm not so sure if that is also a positive.
Yep, we'll see. I mean, it's just tremendous trust that Max Mansfield, the head coach for New Amsterdam, has in his goalkeeper. You know, most every player is going to say, hey, I'm good, I could keep going. And obviously tons of credit to Jesse Cork for in severe pain. I mean, wincing clearly multiple times when, you know, that leg or hip just went into the wrong position.
And here is a ball over the top. And just watching Cork here. And he's going to have the offsides flag.
Yeah, but it's you know, it just comes to trust. You know, his teammate, he has the faith of the coaching staff that if he says he can go, then he's their best option. He started for a reason in tonight's match and in last week's match. So, you know, he's clearly the number one. And you know, the faith comes from the staff and his teammates that if he says he's okay, they're going to go with it.
Some stoppage time you could certainly expect or project another 5 minutes to be added to this one. Barone, and they'll say it's last touched off of New Amsterdam. Meanwhile, what a terrific buildup by Stumptown AC, stringing together perhaps 15 passes, maybe a little bit more. And then the fine ball that was played in for Travis Ward by Reese Williams.
Yeah, it was that initial header. I couldn't quite tell who got that first head of the ball. Flicked it towards the far post to Ward. But, yeah, that was mostly Reese Williams. And a handful of Luis Garcia Sosa as well in the buildup. But it was the good move by Williams and then the great swerving ball with the left foot.
Williams steps forward with a knockdown, the lead for Garcia Sosa. The return here. Ward. And Carpe was not making the run to that end. Follow-up opportunity, Bejarano Navia.
Well, Reese Williams for Stumptown and Daniel Vicente for New Amsterdam have had a good battle going. Vicente, the right back, has gotten forward at times in this first half, and Williams has had to deal with him, and Williams, the left back for Stumptown, has gotten forward a lot, especially lately in the match, and Vicente's had to deal with him a couple of times. both players who grew up as attacking players and are now playing outside back positions. And, you know, in today's games, oftentimes that's what happens. Offensive attacking players early in your career, you find yourself, if you got the pace and the work rate and that ability to get forward and be dangerous, and outside back positions are an attacking position now in the modern game.
Can Stumptown build off of that great sequence? Ward and the whistle, and they'll get Travis Ward a little too handsy on Daniel Vicente. Quick restarts, New Amsterdam, Barone. Siobhan John Brown tried to settle it, broken up. Alex McGrath of Durham in England. Turnover, Malango. And looking for Angulo. Angulo in the air, shouldered it down to the feet of Bajua, broke it up. Ismael Longo to push ahead. Space out wide, Garcia Sosa. Waits for numbers and then tried to slip the pass through. Everybody was too far forward. Fernando Cortez for New Amsterdam and did not have the support around him.
Stumptown had a player back from that last. I don't know if it was Bashua, the contact about 40 seconds ago, but a Stumptown defender still was down in the box, referee checking on him now.
And that's Robert Hines that is speaking to referee Arroyo. Hines, last 2 years with the Oakland Roots. Playing at Notre Dame Dean Namur Division II program in California.
I think they're going to give this back New Amsterdam. Stumptown had possession. They played it out because Hines was hurt. And New Amsterdam does the right thing there, gives it back to him.
So we are now in stoppage time. I think we can fairly estimate 5 more minutes.
Yeah, Cork was definitely down for a while, as was Ward. I think both teams will be okay getting into half here with this score.
Krim, and just the way Cork went up for a little jump there, obviously he is clearly favoring that right hip. He came down and used all of his weight on the left. And we will certainly keep an eye on that, what happens even when he comes out for a brief warm-up for the second half.
Well, I'm not sure I'd be playing it back to him at this point. And now he's got to lump a ball up the field with the right foot. And he's grabbing his hip, right hand on his right hip right now after the fact. You know, he's a goalkeeper that is comfortable playing with the ball at his feet. They play back to him often. He's aggressive, always off his line, outside his box at times. But you would have to say, with how he's feeling right now, a big part of his game is not going to be 100%.
And we'll see if Stumptown AC can take advantage. A couple of early runs from Mali Carpe that nearly materialized. Can that happen again? Foul against New Amsterdam, so here's an opportunity, rather a handball against Angulo.
Yeah, almost surprised the referee didn't caution him there. It was clearly an intentional handball, just a little bit of a brain freeze from Angulo there.
Nice ball laid in, and Williams saw both Carpe and Garcia Sosa making the run in front of them. So New Amsterdam would love for this half to expire as soon as possible. Regroup and really ask Jesse Cork some timely questions and then sort out what they're going to do. Do they go to Muhammad Keita in the second half, and do they have a chance to perhaps organize how they may play with a keeper making his debut in the club? Out wide, Angulo. Martinez knocks down the service.
Yeah, defended well there by Frankie Martinez. New Amsterdam with a couple of back post runs. Boshua was there looking for that cross.
Ward. And Kafari, nice breakup. Ward to take it back. Travis Ward locating Hines. Not a great first touch. Krim. Pressure on Krim. Jacob Krim will get out of it. And a nice ball and decision under pressure for Williams. And now Garcia Sosa relays it over to Williams. Another cross sent in. Numbers in the box. Headed out. It'll be a goal kick. And that was the runner coming down the middle. Again, that's Alex McGrath.
Yeah, it's taken Garcia Sosa a while to get into the match. 10 first 10-15 minutes. Really didn't get a lot of touches on the ball. But since then, he's been involved. And we've seen just how smooth every pass he plays is, just really nice and easy into the path of the player. He's connected well with Reese Williams a couple of times, and you can see Reese Williams really dangerous getting forward, serving that ball with his left foot into the box in dangerous spots on the field. But Garcia is finding his way in the game now in the last 30 minutes.
A takeaway, Fernando Cortez, lead for Angulo, accelerates forward, a look up to goal, then plays it through. Maieli, and the shot, the save is made, Gonzalez. Maieli Malango with an inside opportunity, didn't have a great angle, however. Gonzalez fights it off.
Yeah, watching that near post, Kevin Gonzalez, never want to be beat near post. He kind of felt that was the only place. Malango, who hit it really well, struck a really hard shot there. But good positional goalkeeping by Gonzalez keeps it out of the net.
Big stop, Kevin Gonzalez. Rod Underwood calls him a leader, very good with his feet. A past player of Rod Underwood's coached him and said, take a look at him in the tryouts, give him a chance, evaluate his tape. Only a one-year starter in college at a Division II program, Holy Names University. That's it. For the first half in stoppage time, New Amsterdam and Stumptown AC are scoreless. We'll find out what Max Mansfield does in terms of goalie. We'll hear from Coach Mansfield coming up at the half, an encapsulating interview about the philosophy of the Foosball Project and New Amsterdam FC moving forward. That's coming up when we come back to Warwick. We are scoreless NISA soccer action tonight on MyCujo.tv. You know, it's strange because he landed on his left hip. So it's like, what?
Yeah, but, you know, like he's landing.
It's maybe the,
this turf stands.
One hour from New York City, Hudson Sports Complex is the up-and-coming sports hub of the Hudson Valley. HSC is a world-class training facility owned by professional soccer player Christian Fuchs. Unrivaled amenities include indoor and outdoor fields, a top-of-the-line dome, locker rooms, and more. HSC can host any event from practices and games to tournaments and combines. Come play under the lights at the home of champions. Visit us at hudsonsportscomplex.com.
Max, into year two of this club within the Foosball Project, describe kind of the choices you had to make as a general manager as you continue to grow this club and organization. The locals versus the professionals that you now have access to look at, and how'd you balance that out and continue to balance that out?
Yeah, I mean, I think after the fall season, it was clear we needed to make some change and maybe bring in a couple more seasoned veterans, but that's not to say we're going to do so at risk of losing our identity, right? We're still a club that prides itself on overlooked players. And while we have some more seasoned vets in now, we still have, you know, a high number of guys that are overlooked, you know.
Mm-hmm. One of the notable guys and the great stories in the organization, 33-year-old Sakelly Sylvester. You're starting left back last week. a guy that certainly perhaps could have fallen through the cracks. Just describe how you found him, and perhaps that story might be so motivating to yourself and everybody else that's pursuing an opportunity like his.
Yeah, I mean, we talk about New Amsterdam, especially in the youth academy. We say you come here for a better life. And I think Keeley or Sakili is an example of that. You know, whether it happens at 33 or not, I think there was a lot of a doubt even from within the organization to, you know, put that kind of pressure on a guy like that who hasn't played a pro game. And he's come in and, you know, barring injury, he would have started tonight as well. And he's been absolute class. And it's just a testament to, like you're saying, guys that fall through the cracks, guys that have what it takes to play at this level. They just need somebody to roll the dice on them. And if that's us on a certain amount of players, then so be it. And I'd encourage it to be a blueprint for other clubs to, you know, do the same.
Mm-hmm. Max, you have such a fascinating background, having grown up, being born in Germany, having grown up in both New York City in the West Village and in Germany. So you trialed and came up through the Schalke 04 program and then Cologne, Germany, essentially spending about 2 years there. How does the German influence for you as a young coach still kind of impact you on a daily basis in what you do and how you think through games and evolve yourself?
Yeah, I mean, to the detriment of my playing, but the benefit of my experience, I bounce around between 8 or 9 clubs in a 2-year span. I mean, it moves quick there, but it allowed me to see a lot of different environments, a lot of different dressing rooms, and a lot of different, you know, managerial styles. So I think there's certainly an element of it. There's you know, little things like every NAFC player, when we come to training, when we leave, we shake every person's hand, from the physio to the head coach to the intern. You look every person you're about to go to work with in the eye as you enter and as you depart. And I think those kind of little things maybe come through. Certainly the fines for the players, that has come through as well. We have a hefty fine list, but it's all in the spirit of keeping things transparent, keeping, you know, our work honest as an organization. And I think the guys, you know, after the initial growing pains have grown to like it and you know, be accustomed to it. Mm-hmm.
Lastly, Max, still seeking that first win. What's that going to feel like? And perhaps all this work, perhaps will eventually, there is a path to getting all the hard work it takes to realize getting that first win. How about that journey that it might take that you could get a payoff of that?
Yeah, I mean, I'm a firm believer that if it was results only, we could have gotten a win, you know, a couple months ago or a couple weeks ago, let's call it. But I think the cool thing is if we win now, we win games and we play what I believe is the most attractive brand of soccer or football in the league. So, you know, it's sometimes tough to go against your values to get a result, and I don't think we've done that in the slightest. So, you know, when we win, we can say, you know, we stayed true to our game and in the development pathway of players at any age, and, you know, the proof will be in the pudding then.
Mm-hmm. Max, thank you.
Yeah, thank you guys.
Awesome. Yeah, that's it, because then we're going to throw a break. Fantastic, cool. Max.
Yeah, thanks.
That's a ball played in for Bello. Bello tees it up, gets the shot off! New Amsterdam in extra time has tied up the Cosmos. New Amsterdam has its first goal as a franchise.
McKenzie toward the back post. Really nice ball and into the corner. Another one for New Amsterdam. Let me know. Headed in.
Yeah.
Vicente gives New Amsterdam their first lead as a club.
Like we always do at this time, I go for mine, I get to shine. Now throw your hands up in the sky.
And get pulled over in they new V. The good.
Times they mold you to the haters, I told you. Let the world see how you went. No matter how you seem to them. Fuck them. Fuck them. Fuck them. Fuck them. And people think I'm mad.
So devastated. At times I thought we'd never make it. But now we on our way to greatness. And all that ever took was patience.
Okay, just getting better each day. Stacking that to the cheesecake. Look up to the Lord, we pray. Trying to be my best each day. Until I'm late, the rest of we late. Yeah, to the time being we lit. Hoping I don't let it get all in my head. Now I don't need the money just to sit it.
Go back to training. We'll probably do 3 days a week up until about like mid to late December.
I wish you guys all a happy Thanksgiving for those of you that celebrate it. I know that most of you don't even know what that is.
U17,
best of luck this weekend, and then we'll see each other all early next week.
Walk like Pistol Pete and Pappy Mason. Gave the young boys admiration. Prince from Queens and Fritz from Harlem. Street legends.
Stumptown AC, based in Charlotte, North Carolina region, New Amsterdam. In New York, are scoreless at the half. Ralph Bednarczyk with Sal Rosamilia as we show you some first half highlights. Opportunities early for Stumptown AC. And this is a ball that Maeli Malanga would service across. No one there down the middle. Eventually Stumptown, they've started to gather some possession.
Yep, and then a cross here from Vicente into the box to Boshua, rising up high. It's a big target there. I'd like to see some more of that from Vicente getting forward. And then we see Molly Carpe with just an absolute rocket, rising, just not close enough. He did a ton of work in the first half. And then really the second part of that first half, the last 20, 25 minutes, Luis Garcia Sosa and Reese Williams connected a lot. Reese Williams getting forward, serving some good balls into the box. Cork was hurt on that play. We'll see if he's able to come out in the second half. And then the best chance of the game for New Amsterdam there was a good run by Jose Angulo. I thought maybe a little too unselfish. I think he could have lined it up for a shot from distance. Instead, he lays it off to Malango for a good chance.
Offsides, just a pair for Stumptown as they look to play in. Molly Carpe over the top. Four apiece in shots, 2-1 in corners. Chances, perhaps New Amsterdam probably had the two quality ones from Malango, but then eventually the left flank started to work. Reese Williams with a couple of nice services that led to the Stumptown opportunities.
Yeah, it's an even game. I think both teams were okay getting into half the way it was ended there. It's interesting. We'll see. Stumptown's out early here, and it looks like they've got their entire starting team walking out for the second half. Still haven't seen anybody just yet coming out for New Amsterdam. Keita, Mohamed Keita, the backup goalkeeper, has been warming up the entire halftime here with the substitutes for New Amsterdam. So we still don't know if Jesse Cork is going to be able to continue or not. And you see Luis Garcia Sosa, he's hobbling a little bit, grabbing that upper quad, that right thigh that he got knocked into late in the first half as well.
Sal, how would you evaluate Stumptown AC's keys to the game that we presented earlier, presented by Fruit Tree, their edge in possession that Rod Underwood wanted? How would you evaluate
it? Yeah, well, they had it for sure in the last 15, 20 minutes, and that's when Luis Garcia Sosa really started to find more of the ball. That's what we talked about early. They want to play through him, and they were not able to do it in the first 10 or 15 minutes, but he really got active, really got busy after that.
And then for New Amsterdam, again, they had allowed 9 goals coming in through 5 total matches this spring period. They have to find a way to clean it up on that end.
There was a couple of times early in the first half where the press from Stumptown caused some turnovers from New Amsterdam, but for the most part, I think they've done a pretty good job. Defensively, the last 3.5 matches, I mean, they're coming in 3 straight 1-0 losses. So defensively, they've been good. They can't afford that big error that leads to a goal, because there's still a struggle on the offensive end. Only 2 goals now in 5.5 matches so far this year for New Amsterdam. But they've cleaned it up defensively. Again, they've only allowed 3 goals in the last 3.5 games. And if you can just score a goal a game, you're going to get some points out of that. And I think this is a match, given Stumptown played 2 nights ago, had to travel to get here yesterday. Their 3rd game in 7 days. New Amsterdam at home. You know, for all those reasons, you know, this game you'd have to look at from a New Amsterdam point of view. Well, you want to get that first win under your belt.
Still waiting to see New Amsterdam come out, as Stumptown AC is already prepared for the second half, and perhaps a sign for New Amsterdam to try to determine who's going to be in goal.
Well,
if you're mulling this
change
over, if you're, yeah. Yeah, certainly one change is Bledi Bartic will come in, our first substitute.
He's already handed the referees a substitution card there.
He handled it himself. Bledi Bartic, longtime pro, first substitution presented by Icarus. Bartic from Montenegro, 29-year-old in his first year with New Amsterdam. A goal against the LA Force, not starting tonight, but now he has this opportunity. We'll see if it's Bajua or Angulo. Again, our substitution presented by Icarus.
Yep, last week against Detroit City, Bartic started the match, and at halftime, Bajua came in for Bartic. A similar substitution. And you're right, Ralph, it's, you know, I would guess it's got to be either Angulo or Bajua. New Amsterdam in a 4-4-2, and you would think Bartic has to come for one of those 2 forward spots. Did not see Keita and maybe he just doesn't even know yet. He's certainly ready to go. If he had to start the second half, he took the entire halftime. You can see he's sweating pretty good there. Mm-hmm. He is certainly ready to go. Doesn't have the card in his hand yet, probably because they're just not sure whether, until Cork gets out here, whether he's going to continue or not. But Keita's ready, willing, and able, if called upon, to play here in the second half. And he's played before, hasn't played so far this year, but he certainly has experience at this level and will be very comfortable in the game if he has to play.
Meanwhile, Stumptown AC seeking their second win this spring season. They defeated Maryland 2-1 last weekend on the 8th on Saturday. And had some okay showings. They got the win over New Amsterdam in the Legends Cup in Chattanooga, 2-0 in their very first game together against Detroit City, April 16th. So you can understand that's almost a game where you put an asterisk next to it. And then we're able to pick up a tie against Cal United April 19th. So to go 1-1-1 in the Legends Cup was a positive. Then the victory before the setback on Wednesday night, giving up the early goal that Kevin Gonzalez and his teammates gave up in the 11th minute.
And Stumptown's not a team. They've only given up two goals in a match once, and that was their first game, as you mentioned, against Detroit City, a 2-0 loss. And they haven't given up more than a goal in any match, the four matches since. And they do have one shutout. New Amsterdam still looking for their first shutout ever in a season and a half so far.
Well, Stumptown looks ready, and they've got the energy. They're not showing that this is game 3 and 7 as they patiently wait for New Amsterdam and the starters to come out there. I don't know if there is a clock inside.
Oh, they've been notified for sure by mm-hmm. now. There's no question about that. It's almost at the point where you're wondering if somebody's lost the key to the locker room to let them out. Because this, you don't normally see this happen. They clearly are late coming out. I'm not sure what NISA's stance on these types of things are. Mm-hmm. At some professional levels, you'd be into a penalty situation. Mm-hmm.
In the meantime, we had a nice halftime visit from a guy that you've known a long time, have respected from a distance, Columbia head coach Kevin Anderson, patiently awaiting to have a men's soccer season. He coached Arthur Bajua of New Amsterdam and Stumptown AC's Reese Williams, of course, in college. So he is here watching in the off season. So great to get a visit from him at the half as New Amsterdam has made its entrance here, including Jesse Cork is. We watch how he is moving, and that sign to me, Sal, based on the way he's running, he is going to be the goalie in the second half.
The weapons are on. The gloves are on. He's playing. He's certainly not moving freely and easily, but credit to him. Boy, he is he just refusing to come out, and we saw that last week. You know, he hurt his shoulder late in the match last week. I thought there was an opportunity. I thought he was potentially going to have to be changed last week. I didn't think there was any way, when you saw the pain on his face when his leg was moved in certain areas, I didn't think there was any way he was going to be able to continue in this game. But he's just a tough guy and wants to continue, wants to be a part of potentially that first victory here for New Amsterdam. And quickly, yes, about Kevin Anderson, there's been many, many great players coming through Columbia, and just two really good guys besides impactful players in Arthur Bajua and Reese Williams, and tremendous respect that they had for Coach Anderson, and you see reciprocated as Coach Anderson comes on. He's done a wonderful job at Columbia, and he's brought his two beautiful daughters here with him as they made the trip from their home. He said it took about almost 2 hours for them to get here to come watch his two former players play. And I think each of the daughters had a favorite. One's favorite was Bajua, and one's favorite was Williams, but you can't go wrong with either guy.
It won't be Bajua the rest of this one, though, Sal. Angulo remains in as the other forward, so the change is Bledi Bartic as the substitute. Up top to pair up with Angulo, so the first one of the match. As New Amsterdam looks for the icebreaker, And the opening possession, this segment of the broadcast presented by Hero Life as the second half is underway. And McGrath is immediately bumped and is shaken up.
It just kind of ran into as they were both looking for the ball there. Maeli Malango. Clearly no intent to harm McGrath, but Malango the bigger guy.
Hines, and doing well is Siobhan John Brown. Space for Maeli Malango. And once again, Hero Life brings us this second half, opening 10 minutes. Vicente. Guarnera, Cortez, nice ball out wide, Bartich. So Bledi Bartich, tossing coming through. 28 goals in 46 matches over the course of 4 years for the New York Cosmos senior team and their B team. Did not start tonight, and he's just been in a rut. He's been trying to find it, but so much talent. McGrath, great distribution, came from Gonzalez. Garcia Sosa. Carpe, back to goal. And Carpe tried to go out wide. Breakup, Sal Barone. Malango. Toss coming for New Amsterdam. Maeli Malango with the two best chances for New Amsterdam. 24-year-old. His first season with the club. Just released by New England Revolution 2. Vicente getting past Ward. To the feet of Bartich. Bledi Bartich to continue. And Garcia Sosa, and that's perhaps a good foul, certainly a hard step into by Barone to potentially break up and accelerating Garcia Sosa.
Yep, you call that a professional foul sometimes. And we'll look at Sosa beside Cork here in the second half, who's dealing with an injury. Sosa got a knock late in the first half.
Carpe, nice leave, crafty footwork. Carpe extending to the width as Hines serves it in. Cork, that time from distance, looked pretty good. Able to hop up a bit and handle it. Sal, is it going to be the goal kicks for Cork? Is it going to be going laterally? What do you make of perhaps his limited condition?
I think it's going to be everything. And if I'm Stumptown, I'm going to do just what they did right there. I mean, he's in the match. He's clearly not feeling 100%. If I'm Stumptown, I'm going to serve as many balls into that penalty spot area, see if he's able to come off his line, see if he's able to push off either foot, get some extension into the air, see if he can deal with some contact. I mean, that would be my strategy as often as possible here in the second half.
Stumptown AC is going to make a sub. Molly Carpe is going to exit here, Sal. I think I'm a bit surprised to see it happen so early in the half, 4 minutes in.
Two changes here. Yep. Hines coming out and the other Carpe coming out.
Yep, the other sub.
Bay Kurtz.
Yeah, Bay Kurtz, Crown Point, Indiana, 25-year-old. So these substitutes presented to you by Icarus, and the other sub up top. Malango. Fine, clean breakup made by the holding mid, Giovanni Bejarano Navia. First touch for Kurtz, who's got one of the four goals this year for Stumptown. Ward able to play it out wide, and the other is Giovanni Ramos Godoy, who handles now. Ramos Godoy, great USL championship experience, spent last year with FC Tucson, also 2 years with Orange County. great college career at UC Irvine. Offsides flag up against Stumptown before McGrath could get to it.
Yeah, these early subs, not a complete surprise given that, you know, again, we've talked about it a bunch in this game. One, Carpe really put in a lot of work. Didn't get a ton of touches, didn't have a lot to show for it in the first half, but he was running constantly, pressing, making runs off the ball the entire time. And second match in 3 days here, third match in seven, with not a lot of turnover from game to game in terms of what the lineups were.
Cortez, and you are allowed a total of five subs this year, but over the course of three different substitution periods. In other words, you can't sub in five different times. You got to sub in, at least in one segment, multiple substitutes. A foul coming. Stumptown AC has either played it quick, they have not played the ball over the top. And will they do that here and send some numbers into the box? And again, they'll elect to play it short. Perhaps, again, the philosophy of Rod Underwood to be a ball-dominant possession team as he looks to cultivate that culture.
Well, it's that in New Amsterdam. Back four, really high up, not even taking a line at the 18-yard box, even further out, maybe 25 yards away from goal. So tough to get guys in the box when that's where New Amsterdam is starting their defense.
Ward, as he comes off the sideline.
Now here's the chances now when they have established a little bit of possession deeper in New Amsterdam's half of the field. Here's where you got to get some guys in and around the goalkeeper, get some services into dangerous spots.
Ward to cut it back. Service to goal. Cork remained in, and into the back of the net. Cork took a step forward, and perhaps that's where the injury made an impact. He stayed back. Alex McGrath has been around the six all night. He's the recipient of a fine ball from Ward. It's Stumptown AC that strikes.
Yeah, and here it is, towards the back post. And it's a tough ball for Cork. You know, I don't want to blame that on the injury. Credit to him for trying to continue there. It's a ball with... We wouldn't be shocked if he came off his line and dealt with it, but it's really just a great, great service in a good spot. Beyond the far post, out near the six-yard box. You can just see this. Just flighted perfectly. Nice, soft, floating ball towards the far post. It's beyond the far post. A lot to ask for the goalkeeper to come get that, and certainly not being 100%, decided he had a better chance to save it. Sitting on his goal line, got a hand on it, but it was just a good header, a great cross. And a deserved lead, I would say, at that point, just for that one play right there. Everything about it, a floated cross to the back post. The marking wasn't quite so good there either, too, so.
Now another opportunity, and this one, almost an own goal. Mohamed Kone got in front of the pass. It'll be a corner for Stumptown AC. 54th minute goal, Alex McGrath. Travis Ward on the assist. And Stumptown AC, we'll see if they'll challenge Cork in the air here.
Well, next few minutes real important for New Amsterdam. See if they can manage this. Can't afford to give up a second one. Still loads of time in the match. And you would expect as the game goes on, if New Amsterdam can get some of this possession back here. They really haven't had it so far in the second half. Stumptown's come out the better team. But if they can get back control of the ball, get some possession, you would expect as the game goes on, maybe Stumptown gets tired. But have to keep it 1-0 for now.
Malongo in the open field, pass McGrath. And Malongo, nice ball to the feet of Barnic. Bloody Barnic, and a save is made. Fighting it off, Kevin Gonzalez.
Great reactions from Kevin Gonzalez. A wicked shot there by Barnic. Hand high made it only slightly easier for Gonzalez to make that save, but tremendous reflexes.
Barone, next ball in. Handled by Krim, out, deep throw, New Amsterdam. Oh, you can see Malongo, once he built up steam as he made that long run, that was going to be trouble for Stumptown AC, as here's also Agui Chunga coming in as another substitute for Stumptown just recently, as here's a ball handled by Cork in the air. This segment of the broadcast presented to you by Traffic, with Cork having some traffic in front of him.
Not only that, he got hit in his right hip, pushes off his right leg, gets hit in his right hip, comes down on his right hip. I just can't say enough about how brave and courageous Jesse Cork has been tonight.
I think we've seen enough to at least indicate that he has passed enough tests following the injury that it appears he'll be able to stay in. What tomorrow looks like off of whatever's ailing him, maybe a different story. But New Amsterdam now find themselves trailing 1-0. Cortez and Angulo. And out of tight quarters, Krim plays it forward. Siobhan John Brown, not as active tonight, Sal, than we saw him last week against Detroit City. I thought he was just, he was making not just a lot more runs, but wide and all over the field, that John Brown just seemed to be engaged a lot more in the match last week.
Well, there's an extra player in the midfield for Stumptown. They're playing with five in the midfield, and New Amsterdam's playing with four in the midfield, so it's going to be a little tougher for the New Amsterdam midfielders to find as much possession.
Ball ahead, a nice tackle by Barone to prevent Chunga to get forward. A yellow against Barone, though, on that tackle. And Sal, you may call that a professional foul. Otherwise, if Chunga is able to disengage from that, he may have had an opportunity to shoot.
Yeah, and you see there, I mean, there's the first tackle was fine. It's that afterwards. That first tackle by Barone was actually just picture perfect. There was nothing in it on that. But he was the underdog to get to the second ball, which is why he had to grab Chunga, because he wasn't aware that there was another New Amsterdam defender there that may have been able to come over and help out, but he wasn't going to take a chance. So he gets the caution and a dangerous now free kick for Stumptown.
It's Alex McGrath over the ball on the left. On the right, Giovanni Ramos Godoy. McGrath. Second ball. Return out wide, Ishmael Longo. Service across, backside does not have a runner. Headed out by New Amsterdam. Space here for Baykurtz. Three different Division I programs in his career. Finished up at UNLV. 2 years at Virginia. Started his career 2 years at Liberty. Came up through the Chicago Fire Academy and Real Salt Lake. Still just 25, and someone Stumptown AC was happy to have as one of their three guys that carried over from last year to this year with this new organization and new management. As here is McGrath, as able to get wide, and a good ball for Ward. Travis Ward has a number on the backside. Ward to continue, weaves through, knocked down. Follow-up opportunity came. Clearance by Vicente, Well, right at the edge of that 18, Travis Ward tightroping there and then looked to sell the call.
Well, the game has certainly opened up. Both teams with great chances. And now another foul just outside the box. But some end-to-end action. Gonzalez has been forced to make a great save on Bartich. And Stumptown has had a couple of decent chances. Wondering what they're going to do here.
This is it's an interesting area, one that you may not practice much, Sal. About 4 yards off the 18. So an interesting combination or call here to make with McGrath on the right and Longo on the left to discuss. Stumptown AC has not shown us that they have a lot in terms of in the air on this roster. They are truly also built to be a possession team. Who could be that target? And McGrath, they'll play it out wide. Longo. Service in further. Ward. And it's out of his reach, so a wasted opportunity.
Yeah, I would have just played that right along the six-yard box. Whip one in. Hope it deflects off somebody. If it's your guy, great. If it's a New Amsterdam guy, who cares? Wasted chance.
They'll call the foul on Ward. Goal came in the 54th minute. Stumptown AC has the lead. And to try to finish up a rigorous 7-day period with two wins. Brown able to play through Milongo, rather Kone, Bartich. And New Amsterdam was not going to be in an onside position.
Now, this is a huge game for Stumptown. Detroit City's already into the playoffs later in the summer, as is Chattanooga. So Detroit City's at 3-0, top of the table so far, but that almost doesn't matter to everybody else. Stumptown's in a tied for second heading into this game with 3 points. And if you're the highest ranked team at the end of this spring season, you're going to get into the playoffs later on. And right now they are tied for second with a bunch of clubs on 3 points. But if they can get another three here tonight, they have to feel pretty good. It's only an 8-game season, and they would have 3 games down already and, you know, be in a wonderful position on 6 points if they can get out of here with a win.
The shot deflects, and it leads to a New Amsterdam corner. Their second of the night. Bartich. And does not beat the first defender. And just to follow up on your point, Detroit City has already clinched a spot in the championship game. They will host that July 3rd. The question is, who will they face? Essentially, the winner of the spring calendar will take on Chattanooga, who's already clinched a spot in one part of that semifinal. Let's call it the two spot. So the three spot is open because Chattanooga finished up as runner-up to Detroit City in the Legends Cup. And then we'll reset the deck into the fall season. The plan is the fall and spring season will be one full year in 21-22 as we return to normalcy as NISA looks to take off as a league. Is McGrath played out of his range by Kone, and here comes an ensuing corner for Stumptown.
Yeah, initially some space there for Alex McGrath, who's got the goal so far tonight already for Stumptown, but a nice defense there from Mohamed Kone. You thought there wasn't really a second defender there in support of Kone, and you had to wonder, McGrath probably felt pretty good about those one-on-one chances there, but wonderful defending leading to a corner.
McGrath will take it, spent 2 years at Appalachian State, so he stayed local following graduation, tried out in the open tryout for Stumptown. And Cork, well, he had to jump there and make sure it went over the bar. And that appeared to be ticketed to fall down. He had to play it out. It'll be another corner.
Yeah, he's off his line there, you know, in a good position, and it's a looping header. And I think you're right that that was going to get underneath the crossbar, and Cork had to get that save on it. Here it is again.
Opportunity, another head ball,
flag,
but it's
up.
Offside.
Yep.
Another redirection. Reese Williams put it back across. He flicked it on. It was almost buried by Jacob Krim.
Yeah, Stumptown starting to pick apart a little bit the possession here. They've had it nearly the entire second half, save for one or two chances from New Amsterdam on a counter. But that possession is really starting to open up some spaces in the defense of New Amsterdam. And they've got the work cut out for them here to try to keep it just the one goal against for a while.
Fruit Street presents this next 10-minute segment. Tonight from the Hudson Sports Complex in Warwick, New York. Stumptown 1-0 in the 54th minute from Alex McGrath. Barone. Cortez could not get there. Big stop made earlier by Kevin Gonzalez. Certainly the best save we have seen, at least the one that counts. Jesse Cork, the one that he was hurt on, was outstanding. But the offsides flag was up. That'll be New Amsterdam possession. Hold up a moment with a substitute getting set to come on for New Amsterdam in the 67th minute. They've used just one. And it'll be Daniel Vicente heading off on the far sideline.
Nope, Angulo.
So Max Mansfield has replaced both forwards. And we'll find out who the next guy is in.
He doesn't have shin guards, so he had to run over. We'll see who it is in a second.
I've never seen that before. You're barring your teammate's shin guards.
Yeah, that can't make Angulo happy. He's been pulled off in a 1-0 game. And he has to give his shin guards. Is that Preciado? Yep, Marlon Preciado.
And indeed it is. Marlon Preciado of Hackensack, New Jersey.
Nope.
Check
actually,
that. Who is that? That's Royer.
His.
Nope, indeed that is Preciado. That
okay.
is his
wearing
full name.
72, okay.
Yep.
Last week he wore 32. Today he's wearing 72, Marlon Preciado.
Well, check that 72, Sal. Chris Bermudez is the sub.
All right.
Beg your pardon. Someone that New Amsterdam signed just this week. So he comes on at forward. Our latest sub brought to you by Icarus tonight. In any event, it's a pair of new strikers up top for New Amsterdam.
If at first you don't succeed, as long as we get it right at some point.
Yep.
So it's 72, you're
it
saying?
It is 72, Bermudez.
Bermudez.
And new signing. Somehow he had to find, he's that new that he had to borrow Angulo's shin guards and put him in as he ran onto the field. Reese Williams. And that ball missing to the short side of Cork. It is Kone, played last year with the Tampa Bay Rowdies. Cortez, and he tried to play Barone in. Well, this match has come a little bit more at a standstill for New Amsterdam, trying to move forward. Stumptown AC has built up their pressure a bit differently, more long balls over the top. They've generated some corners. They've got New Amsterdam a little bit on their heels. Cortez Milango stepping around Krim. Then Milango, and perhaps too ambitious with that shot, he did have a runner in Vicente out wide.
Yeah, everybody's got to try to do a little bit extra now, and Milango's had a good game. Two good chances in the first half for New Amsterdam. You know, they just need a goal. We've talked about, you know, you mentioned when Bartich came on that he's, you know, looking for that goal, and certainly strikers can go on a roll. Once they get one, they seem to come in bunches, and then sometimes they go on some cold streaks where they can't find one. Right now, the entire team, they'll just take anything. And sometimes, you know, just one goal relieves some of that pressure. Getting a draw, getting a win is gonna just feel great. And then all of a sudden you can go on a roll. They're not far away. It's their fourth straight now. If it ends like this, their fourth straight 1-0 game. So they're in every match recently. It's just the only thing that's lacking is that goal. And we saw a wonderful save by Kevin Gonzalez. And, you know, they'll take a deflection. They'll take a shin ball in the goal, anything just to kind of get themselves going here. And there's still time in this match.
New Amsterdam now commits a foul. So Stumptown AC can put some numbers in the box. Well, NAFC, they were close to getting one. They had a 2-1 lead against the LA Force April 19th in the Legends Cup. And Max Mansfield talking about when you have an inexperienced team, their mentality was, let's go get the third one and try to lead 3-1 rather than managing the game. Instead, in a quick spurt, they committed a couple of turnovers. It became 3-2 against them as Ward puts it off the body of a New Amsterdam player, so it'll lead to a corner. But that's the process that a new club has to go through. NAFC 0-8-2 overall in all matches last year. 0-5 to start this year, 0-2 in the spring. Sometimes it's about creating your luck. McGrath, good ball that bends in, and Cork had to play it. He parries it to the corner.
Great job by Cork there. That's a dangerous ball again towards the far post, and he punches it, just uses the momentum of the pass and furthers it out of danger.
Ward steps up, gets it back. Travis Ward chipping. Got a nice return from Giovanni Ramos Godoy. And Travis Ward, the left midfielder, has been active.
Yeah, this is a great ball curling towards the far post. And you just see he uses the flight of the ball, the momentum of the ball, and then a closed fist, right-handed punch to just get it completely out of danger. Really good job there by Jesse Cork. And I'm shocked, but as this half is going on, he's looking better and better in terms of his movement, not really favoring the leg. When he came out jogging to start the second half, he looked about 60%, and right now, if we haven't been watching this whole time, we would say there's nothing wrong with him. He's made a couple of wonderful saves here in the second half.
Williams, and it ends up to the feet of Stumptown EC. Rod Underwood has talked about controlling the tempo is something he's trying to establish. Handball came up. Kone. Cortez. And Sal, the guy that exited earlier for Stumptown, Luis Garcia Sosa, it was Agwe Chunga that replaced him. And Stumptown has looked different, I think, because of that. But we saw what Garcia Sosa can do in a good 20-minute clip in the first half.
And we saw him get a knock to the upper part of his right thigh, quad area, late in the first half, and it wasn't quite the same. Tried to give it a go in the second half and just didn't feel that he can continue. And yeah, Stumptown's a team that always looked to play through him. Now he's no longer there. They've got to find other options.
Nearly a fine connection. Cortez saw Malango. So this is Chunga and Garcia Sosa's replacement. And that'll be the foul against Agui Chunga of Clarksburg, Maryland. He has been playing through a number of NPSL teams before his stop here. Next 10 minutes brought to you by this facility, the Hudson Sports Complex, the home these two seasons for New Amsterdam. Takeaway by McGrath, stepping around Kone. And then a challenge by Barone. Barone already has a yellow. Barone already on a yellow. And he gets just a talking to.
That might have been on the first one. I'm not sure. You're right. They're having a talking to, and Barone's got something to say about it. But I think it might have been on that right there. So he tried for an advantage. That play by Barone is not a foul at all. The foul came from Kone. The referee was waiting to see if there was an advantage. None was there, so then he called and pulled it back to that spot. I think Barone was arguing because he knew there was no foul there on him.
Nice back heel pass. McGrath and Kone showing great recovery. Big center back from the Ivory Coast that New Amsterdam found late in the preseason. Ward. And Ward nearly was able to play through Ishmael Longo before it was broken up. And now New Amsterdam a chance to break out with Bartich. But Martinez steps in front. Redwell, Cortez. Space for Longo. Fine breakup by Vicente. 78th minute. New Amsterdam's had one really good chance. Kevin Gonzalez made a save. And Stumptown AC is continuing to move forward pretty well. After making some substitutes, they'll make another one here. So fourth sub now in is, it'll be Elliot Cutts that comes on as he's a backup midfielder, usually in the holding spots from London.
New Amsterdam made two changes as well. Looks like Vicente and Cortez are out. Didn't quite see the two players that came on for them.
Bartich. Nice bending ball across. Played away from Bermudez. So his three subs came in the 78th minute. Barone back for Kone.
36 and 12. So Yusuf Mikhail is one of the subs.
Yep. And Marlon Preciado being the other. Sal Preciado somewhere at wide midfield. And Preciado for Cortez at center attacking mid. That's Yusuf Mikhail. Malango, great turn. Off the body of Kurtz. Deep throw coming, New Amsterdam. Now Bermuda is able to punch it outside. Runner in the front and just played away. Opportunity there for New Amsterdam as they continue through Bermudez as he ran through a Stumptown player in Kurtz. And finally the clearance closer to midfield. Well, New Amsterdam playing with some urgency now during that last two-minute period into the 81st. So Mikaheel is on.
That's a well-timed tackle there by Bay Kurtz. Hasn't been in the match for long. He took a risk going to the ground, making a tackle inside the box. If he doesn't time it right, doesn't get it right, it's a penalty opportunity for New Amsterdam. Good play there by Kurtz. This game almost doesn't feel like it should be this close, the way Stumptown has played in the second half and the chances that they've had. But this is still a one-goal game here with 10-plus minutes to go. New Amsterdam very much alive to get something out of the game. And thanks to Jesse Cork, who's had a big second half, and we were wondering if he would even be able to be fit enough to continue.
Kone continues on a run. And Gonzalez will pick it up and bring it to safety. So Mikaheel on for Bicente at right back. He made the team. He had to convert himself to that position, more of a center mid. So perhaps a different attacking option late in this match. Kone. And Preciado brings something a bit different. Noted more as a finisher in the box. Max Mansfield loved the way he can shock a game, change a game with immediate energy. Who will it be for New Amsterdam to get them that significant goal? They had two ties last year, including a late tie against the Cosmos last August. Opportunity in the box that nearly carried through. That was Preciado that had it at his feet.
Again, Kurtz going down to the ground to clear that one away at the last moment.
Mikaheel sends in, and Kurtz then heads it away from the opportunity for Malongo. Turned over. Barone. Barone then plays it all the way across dangerously to the top of the box. Another nice service that was set up on a platter for New Amsterdam had anybody been in the vicinity.
And that's two times in the last 5 minutes or so that Barone's put a good ball into a good spot in the box, but there hasn't been a New Amsterdam runner there.
Siobhan John Brown. Next ball coming through, and it'll be a goal kick. This gives Stumptown, or it will be a corner rather. 84th minute, New Amsterdam. How many more of these are going to get? Kone, could it be an obvious target? Bermudez on this service. Ball in, and that was John Brown, rather Kone in the air. They'll say last touched Stumptown.
Yep, I think Kone headed it down off the back of a Stumptown player and out for another corner.
Now they'll play it short. Bartich, the return. Bermudez accelerates, edge of the box, continues. Save made, Gonzalez.
Yeah, nice move. You thought Bermudez was going to get it on that left foot and try to curl one toward the far post, and said he beat a man and got himself a little bit closer. Good save, Gonzalez.
Third in succession. Pass Kone, punched out, Gonzalez. Next ball back in the box. Target man was Bartich, handled by Frankie Martinez. Williams, the clearance. And Stumptown AC has now been on their heels for a while. And a stoppage as Kevin Gonzalez is down on all fours.
Yep, and it was headed away by Frankie Martinez with some pressure there behind by Bloody Bartich. And Kevin Gonzalez came charging off his goal line, coming for that cross that never got to him because Frankie Martinez was able to head it away. And Gonzalez just, you'll just see he runs right into the back of Bardich. There's the header clear.
Martinez, another clearance.
Yeah, New Amsterdam looking for a potential handball there. There was just a crowd of players, couldn't see what happened, but here's some calls for handball from the bench area.
Icarus brings you this final segment. Should be some time in stoppage time, maybe another 3-4 minutes that New Amsterdam could budget. Williams enters in. Malongo, and now chips it forward, and to try to power through. Martinez is the one that fouls Maeli Malongo. So this is the best spot that New Amsterdam has had a restart in all night. It'll be in the 87th minute, and one they can ill afford to waste.
Yeah, and Bardich wants on this, so I'm not sure if he thinks he can have a shot from this distance, probably a good 35 yards out. But he immediately ran over to pick this ball up and get on it. Now, they've got some big targets. He can curl this one towards the far post. Gonzalez has done a good job coming off his line, but he's 6 foot in heels, maybe.
Whatever it takes, cleats, heels. Instead, he sails it.
Yeah, I thought Bardich was thinking. To me, it's maybe just on the fringe of the distance there, 35 yards. But as confident as he was in going and getting that ball, putting it down, and I thought he had shot on his mind the entire time there. No problem with it if you force Gonzalez to make a save in that situation. It's been a good response from New Amsterdam since they gave up the early goal in the second half. They've created some opportunities, especially this last 5 or 6 minutes. Three corners, that free kick there. A lot of fight in this team, as we've said the last 2 weeks, Ralph. They're very close. They're heading in the right direction, and they're very close to start to put some results together, and there's still an opportunity tonight.
It's just the cruelty of soccer and building a new club. Stumptown in that same building process. They'd love to find a way to manage the rest of this game. Next weekend, Stumptown will host Cal United, and now a card has been given against Stumptown.
That's for time wasting, mm-hmm. which you would expect in a 1-0 game on the road, any chance you can.
And now Stumptown can manage the rest of these remaining minutes. McGrath into the corner. Bermudez for New Amsterdam enters in. Make a heel wide. John Brown waits for numbers. Kafari. And now Malongo. John Brown. Now the following service. Knocked back. Stumptown EC got enough blue shirts in the way. New Amsterdam, perhaps the final corner of the match in the 90th minute. Again, we project, I'd call it 3 minutes of stoppage time.
Sounds about right.
Bermudez was effective during the last flurry of corners. Punched out by Gonzalez, second ball, and Gonzalez grabs it. Now, Stumptown has not left anyone unmarked. They've defended those corners well. And now a card will come out against New Amsterdam. The hit on Elliott Cutts. So stoppage time has arrived tonight in Warwick. Stumptown AC coming up from the Charlotte, North Carolina region. Martinez will play it to the corner rather than send it on target. Chunga with a good ball wide. And Stumptown showing patience. And they know they're just seconds away. Micah Heel ahead. New Amsterdam will be back home on June 2nd against Cal United. Cal United has something of a phenom. An 18-year-old named Chile Arenada. Looking forward to watching him. That has gotten a lot of attention about his play and his potential for down the road and what he might mean to NISA as a guy that could jump ahead in his career. Chile Arenada, a center attacking mid, looking forward to bringing you that one on June 2nd. It'll be a two-week break ahead for NAFC. That's it. Stumptown AC comes to New York, and they finish off this tough stretch of 3 games in 7 days with a win. Alex McGrath, the goal in the 54th minute. Stumptown hung on. They converted on a fine pass from Travis Ward. Stumptown AC now picks up its second win this spring season.
Now you got to give Stumptown just a ton of credit for getting another 3 points here. Their second game in 3 nights. They've now played 3 matches to start this season. They've got 6 points. They're in a very good position just before midway through this season here to advance into a playoff situation. You can see the a little bit of frustration, dejection there from New Amsterdam. They know they're close, but they just can't find that goal. They're getting better. It's the fourth straight 1-0 defeat for New Amsterdam. And you just wonder, you know, who it's going to come from, when it's going to come, and you see some heads hanging low on that New Amsterdam sideline.
Sal, how about our play of the game presented by Fruit Street?
Well, it's got to be the goal. Travis Ward with a great floated ball towards the far post. There's 2 players there that are kind of opened. 2 had a chance at it. It was Chunga was there. But here it is, the cross, the assist from Ward picks it out, and it's Alex McGrath at the back post, times it perfectly, and is able to get it by Cork, who was phenomenal tonight, but just couldn't stop that one. And one was all Stumptown needed as they get their second shutout on the year and second victory.
McGrath with his second of the season, all tough holding mid. Typical box-to-box guy that found a seam, and Ward delivered a beauty. His second assist of the season. Kevin Gonzalez, not to be forgotten. 2 fine saves. Jesse Cork persevered tonight for New Amsterdam despite an injury, made it through, but it was not enough. 1-0 the final. Stumptown AC the win. For our entire crew tonight, for our producer and director, Dave Turner, for my partner, Sal Rosamelia, my name is Ralph Binorczyk, saying so long and good night. You've been watching soccer from the National Independent Soccer Association on MyCujo.tv.